Good morning, students. I am Purnima. I welcome you to my class of English. Today, children, I am thinking to have a change in your classroom, and I am not thinking to teach you any lesson from your honeydew or it so happened. I am thinking to change something. I want to teach you related with the writing section, and for that, I have decided that I will be teaching you notice writing. So first of all, you should know what is a notice. Okay, many time when you were in the school, a notice used to come to you related with the school timing or a school uniform, or certain if Independence Day is going to be celebrated, at what uniform you have to wear, at what time you have to come, at what time you have to leave from the school. So the notice is about all this thing. Now, so first of all, what is a notice, that I have to tell you. Now, children, notice, I'm reading, and children, then you can see. A notice is a written or printed information. So what is a notice? A notice is a written or printed information that can be in the form of official statement. Okay, so it is an official information. Okay, it can be written and or the in the form of official statement of public importance. That means, children, a lot of people, a notice should reach to lot of people. That means it should be publicly informed. You cannot inform one student or two student or one people or two people. You have to address a large group. The notice should reach the maximum people. It provides an information about an event that is about to happen or has happened. Now, children, in notice, what is a notice actually? It is a type of information. And children, it provides an information about an event, that is what is going to happen or what has happened. Okay, so the notice is about two things. It is an information like what is going to happen. Okay, and or it has happened already. So for this, we have to give notice. Okay. Now, children, there is a particular type of format is there in the notice, and not only that, children, I will be telling you about what is the format of a notice, and children, what is the content of the notice, how you express the notice, what should be the word limit. It is a short composition. What is the meaning of short composition? Short composition means, children, not more than 50 words. A notice should not be written more than 50 words. Okay. There are two type of composition in the writing section. First is long composition and the other is short composition. Short composition is, I think, it's about not more than 50 words. And long composition, your letter writing is there, your story writing is there. So these will come under the category of long composition. Okay, so your notice is a short composition. Now, students, there are various type of notice which I will be telling you how to write. Okay, now, notices are of two types. One is the public notice which come in the newspaper, okay, and the other is the notice for school and colleges. Like you people are in a school, you sometimes get notice to for the payment of the fees, or children, if some chief guest is coming on Independence Day, then at what time you have to arrive, at what time the function should take place. Okay, any notice can be of any type. So that notice should be informed to the student, in which all the relevant information should be there. All right. And the other type of notice is a notice in the newspaper. Like suppose you have to change your date of birth. Okay. Or suppose you have to change in your name. That is too difficult nowadays, but if you want to change, you can change it, but then you have to inform to your near and dear one through the newspaper. So children, notice is a source of informing the important thing. Okay, It can be the notice related with school and colleges. It can be a public notices which is there, which comes through media. Like children, we are here living in a lockdown. Okay, we are all nowadays living in a lockdown. And children, a notice was there by the government that till this date the school will remain closed. Okay. Till the people will wear mask when they will go. People had to use sanitizer the way they have to wash their hands. So this is a type of notice which came through media, from the television, from the newspaper. The market will remain closed from such and this and this time. Strict rules and regulation will be followed on Saturday and Sunday for the lockdown. If the people will not put mask, heavy fine may be there on that people. So how do we know all these things? This is a type of notice which is given by the government through media. It reaches us. Okay. So children, notice can be through newspaper or media. Notice can be in the school also, like what your teacher says. And children, notices are of many types. Okay. Notices are not one type, it is of many types. Okay, like I will be teaching you notice related with events, notice related with happenings. What is a notice related with event? Suppose if a debate competition is there in the school, you get a notice from the house in charges or from your class teacher or from your subject teacher that a debate is going to take place in the school at such and such date, in such and such time, then the venue and everything will be discussed, the topic, okay, who, what, how many people will be there in the debate for the motion, against the motion, okay, then the interjection. So all this thing you come to know through the school notices. So this is a notice related with events happening. If some happening is there in your school, like on 5th June you have celebrate Children Empowerment Day, so the chairman of the school is coming for tea plantation, or your principal of the school is going to have tree plantation on Empowerment Day, okay, or some fete is organized, or football match is organized, basketball team is coming. So these are the happenings in your school. Your sports day is going to be there. Your annual function is going to be there. So lots of events and happenings are there in the school. Okay. The other type of notices is there for is very important notice which may come in your examination is related with lost and found. If you have lost your geometry box, if you have lost your identity card, then how you will write the note? Not only that, children, if you have found something in the school playground, like you have must have found some watch or some children, maybe a mobile phone, maybe a watch, maybe a geometry box, maybe a diary, maybe a book, then how you are going to write that notice will be related to found. Then, children, if your school is going to take you to picnic or for educational tours or travel, so that will be some other type of notice. It will be a notice related with tours and travels. Okay. Then children, notices is there for appeal and warning. Like in the case of COVID-19, government is appealing to the people to have put a mask. Okay. Please don't go outside your house. Please keep social distancing. So what are these? This is a type of appeals which comes to you in the form of notice. Then children, change of name or residence or company or bank account, that can also become under the special type of notice. Then children, there will be a notice for meetings also. Okay, so you have to, children, I will be telling you about different type of notice. Okay, now the most important thing which I will be telling you about the format. Children, then you have to write the content. While writing the content, you have to see the all the important points should be written there. That children, you can say only by telling what, when, where, how. You have to put all this question by yourself, then only you will write the good content, okay, expression. It relates to the overall organization and relevance of the content, as well as grammatical accuracy should be maintained. Okay, so this is a types of notice, and I told you that few types of notice is very important related with your syllabus. That is, one type of notice is there, which is related with events and happening. Okay, that will surely become. Then other type of notice can come in your examination related with lost and found, and then with tours and travel. Children, while writing the notice, you have to keep few things in mind. First, the name of the organization or institution should be there in the capital letter. This I will be telling you while writing the format of the notice. Then children, in the format, the second word, okay, in the first line you will write notice with the what I will tell you, with the capital letter you will write the name of the institution. In the second line you will write notice with the capital letter. In the third line, children, you have to write the heading or title of the notice. Then you have to write the date, and afterward, children, you have to write an eye-catching heading. That your heading should be written in such a way that anybody who reads the heading, they will come to know immediately that what is this notice is about. This you have to think. Okay, and then children, it should be in brief. All the relevant points should be there. Your notice should be brief and it should be precise. The content must include complete information. The content must include complete information. The purpose of the notice should be very clear. In the beginning only, when a person will read the notice, he or she will be knowing that what is the purpose for writing the notice. I mean to say, what that notice is about. If anybody will read that, immediately they will come to know that what that notice is about. Okay, so after writing the content, children, you have to write the name and the designation of the person who had written the notice. Designation is a must. Without that, your notice will be incomplete. And children, language must be very simple, very lucid, okay, and must be written mostly in third person. All right. The notice should be there in a box. So when we write the notice, a box should be drawn for the notice. So now, children, you will be writing the format of the notice. What you will be writing? The format of the notice, which I will be telling you, which is there on the board, and I will be telling you about that format. Children, now I have written, if the format of the notice I will be showing you, I have written it on the board. Okay, so please see it and better note it somewhere, otherwise you will forget. Okay, so children, when you have to write a notice, you have to draw a box. When you have to write a notice, when you write a notice, you have to draw a square box, okay, which I have drawn it. You can see a box is there on the board. Now children, first thing, you have to leave one line here, and then children, in the second line, you have to write with the capital letter. Remember, you have to write this with the capital letter, name of the institution. Okay, name of the institution is the name of the school or the college or the office where you are working or the school where you are going. So your name of the institution will be there and the place. Okay, then children, in the third line, you have to write notice with the capital letter. You have to write notice with the capital letter. Of course, the most interesting part is your title or the heading. Okay, you have to write the heading here. Then children, date, and you can see the way I have written the date. This type of date we write in the letters also. You can see how I have written the date. 31st July, small comma, 2020. Now children, July, like suppose if you have to write September, you cannot write SCPT. You have to write the full name of the month. And after writing the name of the month, you have to put a small comma here, as you can see on the board. Then children, leave one line. Now children, this is for neatness. Leaving line, I am telling, it is not a rule, it is only for neatness, so that you can get good marks in the examination. Now the content of the notice should be there, and I will be telling you that how to write the content of the notice. After writing the content of the notice, children, you have to leave one line, and you have to write the name and designation. You have to write the name and you have to write the designation. So I'm telling, this is the format of a notice. Okay, this is the format of a notice. You have to draw a box. Okay, you have to leave one line here. You have to write the name of the institution. You have to write the name of the place. Then you have to write notice with the capital letter. You have to write a nice heading. Okay, as soon as the people will read your notice, they will come to know that what this notice is about. And children, you have to write your the date. You can see how I've written 31st July, small comma, 2020. Okay, then content I will be telling you when I will be giving writing one notice for you. I will be telling you how to write the content. And then of course you have to write the name, children, your full name, your surname, and your first name and surname. Children, in designation, you can write if you are a secretary of the school, then write. If you are the principal, if the class teacher, whatever designation you have, that must be written. And after leaving one line, children, then you have to close your box. And generally, notice is written in 50 words. Generally, notice is written in 50 words. So students, the most important thing I have told, what are the important characteristics of a good notice, to write a good notice, that I have discussed with you. Now, I told you notices are of many types. The most important notice is the notice related with events and children happening. Events and happening in the school. Okay, and children, there are many types of notices are there, like notice related with lost and found, notice related with tours and travels, appeal notice. Okay, so many types of notice you will be having. But the most important notice is events and happening. So I'm going to do one such type of notice which is related with events and happening. So what you have to do, first you have to listen my question, and then you will see how I'm going to write that notice. Now children, like a letter, you have to read the question related with notice very carefully. Because children, lot of content will be given in the question itself. So you have to read the question, and children, you have to note down what is the important thing is given in the question related with the notice writing. So I am going to read one question, but before reading the question, I would like to give you some tips related with the notice for events. Okay. Children, first of all, notice for events is related with the various competition which is there held in the school. First thing, it is related with the competition, like you are having debate competition, you are having group song singing, group song competition, Hindi debate, English debate, okay, then poster writing competition. So many competition you are having in your school, children. So if any competition is there, you get a notice. Suppose if you are having a debate competition is there, you get notice by the school or by the teacher or by the subject teacher that what was the topic of debate, what is the time limit, in which date it should be there. Okay, how many minutes you have to speak for, for or against, or you are the interjector. So many things you have to, children, you will be getting in that notice. If you will write a notice related with debate competition, you have to give a lot of information which I have told just now. Then celebration. If it is an Independent Day celebration is there, or a Republic Day celebration, or annual sports day, okay, or annual function. So children, notice you have to write related with that. Okay, then if some cultural festival is there, then you have to write the notices. And children, sometimes children school or have lot of school, they have winter carnival, or children fete we are having, or Holi celebration, or Christmas celebration. Okay, so children, then again we have to write notices. Okay, so these are the things which is related with sports, with events. These are the notice which will come under the category of events. Okay, children, when this type of notice related with event is there, then you have to write, I'm dictating, and you have to write some important point, like first, who organized that event? What is the first point? Who is the organizer of that event? Then, what is the occasion? What is the purpose? What is the occasion? And what is the objective? Okay, then children, date, time, venue, duration, okay, then topic, if it is a story writing competition, then what topic, if it is an essay writing competition, then what topic, if it is a debate competition, then what topic, okay, then children, who can participate in, what is the essential qualification, or the criteria, or the eligibility, or the condition, okay. Now children, who can participate it? The teachers has to select according to the eligibility, according to the condition, according to the qualification also sometimes. Okay, so this is very important. And then children, last day for registering your name. After that, even if you are interested, you want to take part, nobody is going to give you any chance. So last day for registering names, or children, if any amount is asked, so what is the last day for submitting that amount? Okay, that should be there. Any specific instruction is there or not? Suppose if you are taking part in a inter-school debate competition, so that instruction is given by the teacher that you have to put your uniform. You cannot put your gender or party dress or formal dress. Okay. You have to put your eye cards. You have to tie your hair in a nice manner. So this all a teacher see. Then children, at the last, you have to write the name and you have to write the designation. You have to write the name and you have to write the designation. So finally children, I am going to give you one notice. And that notice is related with poster making competition. A very common competition, which I think is very common in all the school and colleges. Now, children, I'm going to read the question and just see what things are given in the question. Write a notice for the 10th All India Poster Making Competition to be held in your school, okay, on 18th November 2020 from 12:30 p.m. Construct the other essential details. So this is the question. Children, a poster making competition is there in all at the children for the 10th All India Poster Competition making is there. And children, it is going to be held, you can say not 18th but 14th November. Okay, on the day of Children's Day, 14th November 2020. So and children at 12:30 p.m. it is going to start. So children, how to write that notice? Now children, here you can see if the name of the school is not given, then children, here, once again I revise the format with you. Name of the institution, place, notice, heading, date, content, and name and designation. These things should be there when you write a good notice. Now students, you can see children how I've started my notice on the board. So children, this notice is related with poster making competition. So children, you have to write Army Public School Varanasi. If the name of the school is given in the question, then write that name. If it is not given, then you can write the name of any school. So it's better, children, you have to write the name of your own school. Okay, so Army Public School Varanasi. See, I have written in the capital letter, Army Public School. Now everything is there with the capital letter, small comma is there, and then Varanasi. Okay, second line you have to write, first line you have to leave blank, second line you have to write with the capital letter Army Public School Varanasi with a small comma here. Third line you have to write notice, again that too should be written with the capital letter. Then children, you have to write the heading. See here, I have written the heading poster making competition, and that heading is written with the capital letter too. Now here the date, I have told you the manner how to write the date. The full month written, the name of the month is always written with the capital letter, and 31st July, 2020. Alright. Content I will be telling you right now, and then I will be telling you what name and what designation you will write. So children, whenever you write a notice, what you have to do, you have to draw a box. You have drawn a box here. Army Public School, Varanasi. Capital letter, notice, capital letter, poster making competition, capital letter, date, like this. Okay, so student, now I am going to read the notice. Now whenever you have to write the content of the notice, you start with one line. Okay, there are many ways of writing, but which I am telling the line, that would be very easy and you will not write your notices wrong. So children, what you will write, how you will start? All the students are hereby informed. So how you will write the content of your notice, how you will start a student? All the students are hereby informed. Okay, so that content you have to write it here. You will be writing here. All the students are hereby informed that the school is going to organize. Listen, once again, all the students are hereby informed that the school is going to organize the 10th All India Poster Making Competition. Now children, this we have read the question and we are taking this down from there only. So once again I read, all the students are hereby informed that the school is organizing the 10th All India Poster Making Competition on, now children you have to write all the information, on 14th November, 2020. Okay, where? In the school auditorium. In the school auditorium or in the school assembly ground, that means venue is a must, you have to write the venue. From 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. or children, the time was given from 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. from 12 p.m. to 1:30 p.m. Okay, so the time was also given, what I think I have given the time 12:30. So you can write from 12:30 p.m. to 1:30 p.m. It is an opportunity for budding artists to show their talent. Okay, so children, now the topic for the poster making is child labor. For junior category, that is from 4 to 6. And children, topic for senior category is drug abuse. That will be from class 8 till class 11th. Interested student, now children, after writing this, interested students can register themselves with the undersigned. Now this word undersigned is very important. I will be telling the meaning when I will read this line. Interested students can register themselves with the undersigned letters by 10th November, 2020. For further details, contact the undersigned. Now children, who is this undersigned? Okay, if the name is not given, then you have to write any name. Okay, and children, you have to write the designation. So you can write any name, children. Sonakshi, secretary of the art club. So this is the designation, and children, then you have to close your box here. After writing the designation, leave one line, or even if you will not leave one line, that would also be okay. Then children, you have to close your box, and in this way you have completed all your notice. So according to the format, name of the school institution should be written with the capital Varanasi. Name of place written with the capital, notice is written with the capital, the whole heading is written with the capital, and then you can see children this date, content, I've told you all the necessary information, how to end the notice, that also I've discussed with you, and then the children test name and designation. So with this, I conclude this chapter of notice writing here. In my next tomorrow video, I will be making one more video related with notice writing. So with this, I conclude my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.